Multiplication of bacteriophages. Bacteriophages are viruses which infect the bacteria. They live on bacteria. So they can multiply by two alternative mechanisms. They are lytic cycle and lysogenic cycle. Lytic cycle and lysogenic cycle. In lytic cycle, the end of the lytic cycle, the host can going to die. But in lysogenic cycle, the host remain alive. That is the difference between these two mechanisms. So both are multiplication of bacteriophages only, but here T2 bacteriophages are involved for their multiplication. At the end of the multiplication, the bacterial host is going to die, then only the new progeny can release. So this is lytic cycle. It means the phages which are involved in the lytic cycle, they are called virulent phages. Virulent phages. It means damaging, causing death. The phages causing death to the bacterium cell after completion of multiplication, their multiplication. So you are seeing the procedure of lytic cycle here. So first, the bacteriophage can infect the bacterium. So the lytic cycle is said in many steps. So the first step is adsorption. Adsorption is nothing but of attachment or attach. So first, the viral particle, the viriaid or bacteriophage, attach on the surface of the E. coli bacterium, because it is bacteriophage. Where it can live? It live on the bacterium. Okay, so you are seeing the bacteriophage here. The bacteriophage is first attached to the surface of the bacterium. So that is called attach or adsorption. After adsorption, here the bacteriophage has tail pins and tail fibers, tail plate. It penetrate the tail plate inside of the cell wall. There it makes small hole. Through that hole, the DNA, the viral DNA, is entered inside of the bacterium. It means here the main purpose of to attach the bacterium is the DNA multiplication. The DNA, before multiplying, it have to enter into the bacterium cell. So you are seeing here the bacteriophage is attached on the surface of the bacterium. There it make the small hole. Some of the bacteriophages are release the lysozyme enzyme to dissolve the cell wall of bacterium before the entry. So here, after adsorption, it makes small hole on the surface of the cell wall. Through the pores, the DNA is entered inside of the cell. So that stage is called as penetration. Okay, you see here inside of the bacterium, two types of the genomes. One is bacterial DNA, another one is viral DNA, that is integrated DNA. So the protein coat is left outside of the bacterium after transfer of the DNA inside of the bacterium. So you are seeing the protein coat is left. The left protein coat outside of the bacterium, that is called ghost. Okay. The next stage, that is latent stage. Latent stage means it is a biosynthetic stage. Biosynthetic stage. So what is the purpose for entry? The purpose of entry is for multiplication, production, replication of viruses. So you are seeing here the bacteriophage, the DNA is entered inside of the bacteria. When it is entered inside of the bacteria, the bacterial DNA going to inactive, sometime it is going to disintegrate also. Okay, the viral DNA show dominance And here the viral particle, remaining viral particles are synthesized. That's why this stage is called as biosynthetic stage. Again, this stage is divided into two steps, eclipse stage and maturation stage. Eclipse stage means entry, DNA entry, viral DNA entry to formation of formation of viral particle. So between the duration is called ellipse stage. So they specially the biosynthetic pathways are done. The head, it means the protein coat, the head, the nucleic acid, it means there is a replication of nucleic acid, DNA. So they are prepared or synthesized in that stage. So during that stage, the protein particles, capsomeres or tail or sometimes nucleic acids, they are synthesized. Okay, that is eclipse stage. But what is maturation period? Maturation period means first head or protein coat produced separately and nucleic acid produced separately, they are bind to form as a mature bacteriophage. That stage is called maturation period. Okay, so the biosynthetic phase is said as two stages. One is eclipse stage, another one is maturation stage. Eclipse stage is started with entry of viral DNA into bacterium from to preparation of progeny, formation of progeny. So the duration period is called eclipse stage. At maturation stage, then the progeny is matured. After that, they come into the end of the stage. What is the end of the stage? That is lysis stage. So already the cycle is said as lytic cycle. Lytic cycle means the end of the stage have the lysis of bacterium. So the phages are called virulent phages. You are seeing here at the lysis stage, the particles, the viral particles are produced inside of the bacterium. When they are get matured, they releases the lysozyme enzyme. So the lysozyme enzyme can make the digestion of the cell wall of bacteria. Okay, so with the help of lysosome, the cell wall is cleaved, then the progeny is released outside. So what happened here? Finally, the bacterium cell wall is cleaved, the bacteria is died, okay, and the progeny are released. So they are virulent phages. So here the number of progeny are we said in the form of burst size. So burst size means approximately 50 to 200 bacteriophages are released within one lytic cycle. Okay, so the number is said in the form of burst size. Burst size is nothing but of released virus particles within one lytic cycle. So this is the lytic cycle. So when you come to the lytic cycle, what are the highlights here? First, the viral particle is attached to the bacterium, that is adsorption. So then entry of the viral DNA into the bacterium, that is penetration. Then next, biosynthetic stage. At that stage, the head and tails and DNA particle are synthesized separately. At maturation stage, they matured. Then lysis stage, they are going to release by killing of the bacterial cell. Okay, these are the steps are involved into the lytic cycle. So the phages which are involved into the lytic cycle, they are called virulent phages. This is the one of the mechanism of multiplication of bacteriophages. Then another mechanism, another cycle. What is that? That is lysogenic cycle. Lysogenic cycle. So it's seen in coalface bacterium. Coalface viruses. So here, what are the steps are going on here? You see here, first the bacteriophage is attached on the surface of the bacterium. So that is common in the lytic cycle also. So the DNA is penetrated, or the DNA is entered into the bacterium. Then you see here, the viral DNA do not dominate the bacterial DNA in this case. If viral DNA dominates the bacterial DNA, means there is a happening of lytic cycle. But the viral DNA do not show any dominance onto the bacterial DNA, but it is integrated inside of the bacterial DNA. You see here, it can joined with the bacterial DNA. So you see here, this is the hybrid DNA. The hybrid DNA is called prophase DNA. So what are the DNAs are present here? The part of the DNA is bacteria and another part of the DNA is virus. Okay, so it is a combination, it is a mixture, it is a hybrid DNA. So the entry of viral DNA, it can integrated into the bacterial DNA and form as a hybrid DNA, that is called prophase. Okay, then here already I told, if the viral DNA is dominant, means the bacterial DNA going to become inactive, then that entered into the